Digimon Seekers is the latest story to come out of the Digimon franchise, but this time it's a little bit different. While we usually have stories in the form of anime or manga or even the video games, this one is a web novel, which is a completely new way to consume Digimon media. While we have had Digimon novelizations in the past, basically the novelization of Digimon Adventure is all I can recall at least, that one was only released in Japanese. This web novel, along with being released online, will be serialized weekly, and it'll be officially translated in three languages: English, Japanese, and simplified Chinese. This means that if you know one of three of those languages, you won't need to wait for a fan translation. You'll be able to consume it right away. So unless for some reason they put on some weird region locking, it means that it's pretty accessible, which is something I'm a huge fan of. It feels like they're actually taking into account that people from around the world like the Digimon franchise, and it's not just Japan. So big fan of it being released in English, at least as somebody who is fluent in the English language and is like intermediate in the Japanese language, I am definitely going to be reading it in English, as that is my native language. In any case, I want to just go over everything we know about Digimon Seekers so far, because I am very excited for this new iteration of the Digimon franchise. I love the Vital Bracelet, I love that they're tying it into it. It also seems to be another love letter to the franchise. In the trailer we see the Digimon Axel. But in any case, let's go over what we know already about Digimon Seekers. So we know that it's going to be serialized weekly in three languages, Japanese, English, and simplified Chinese, starting from April 3rd, 2023, which feels very close. I'm really excited they're doing something so close by. I thought we might have a bit of a break between things after Ghost Game, but it looks like we're jumping straight into something new. So it's described as a world that's different from the real world of mankind, the digital world. So that's fairly typical for what we know about Digimon. So the digital monsters Digimon inhabit the cyberspace on this network. The discovery of AI lifeform Digimon cast light and shadow. Also, should go without saying that this is just reading from the official Digimon Seekers website, and it's been clearly machine translated into English. I'm assuming that the actual novel will be human translated, not machine translated, because some things read a little bit weirdly when being machine translated. So we've got human society, where everything is managed by networks. Eiji Nagazumi is 19 years old. He's a loser cracker who earns daily money from dangerous work related to the digital world. One day he's given a certain Digimon along with the latest Digimon doc, the Digimon Linker, by Professor Rusenji, who is an authority at Tokyo Denno University. The encounter with the wolf-type Digimon Lugamon, who wears a mysterious interface on his forehead, changes Eiji's dull daily life. There's also another character called Judge, who I believe is Leon, who is my favourite character because he is blonde with a similar haircut to myself. He is a righteous hacker who hates crackers, so he doesn't get along with Eiji, I guess. The 11th Investigation Section of the Metropolitan Police Department's Cyber Crime Division, that's a mouthful, which deals with Digimon crimes, Eiji tries to infiltrate them at the request of Rusenji. Then there's a large-scale cyber terrorism being planned. What is the special skill mind-linking? What is the lost pass of Lugamon and its true specs? Will Eiji win in the digital world and achieve the ultimate life reversal? The story of Digimon Chaos begins, a new project developed with novel trailer products, which is funny that they've just written novel trailer products, because that's what they're advertising to be for Digimon Seekers. It's the novel, we get some live action trailers, and we get products. It feels interesting that they're just marketing as novel trailer products, because most things get trailers, we know that. Products come hand in hand with everything Digimon related, you gotta make some money somehow, and novel is the thing. So it's just interesting to me. So in April 2023, the novelized serialization is scheduled to start on Digimon Web and others. And we get some information about Lugamon, who is a demon beast Digimon that is speculated to be an experimental prototype Digimon, so similar to Dorimon and Rudimon, from before Digimon were discovered, because it has an old-fashioned interface on its forehead. It is said that the data of a demon wolf that appears in the mythology of the real world is embedded in the deepest part of its digicore, and it sometimes shows violent behaviour that is unmatched during its growth period. At first glance, it looks like a cute puppy, which it does, but if you touch it carelessly, you will get a painful counterattack. It has a tendency to primarily recognize beings that can control itself, and although it is difficult to tame, it can be a reliable partner if a relationship of trust can be established. I feel like that goes without saying for all Digimon. Its special moves are Howling Fire, which shoots flames imbued with magical power from its mouth, and Spiral Bite, in which it bites and rotates with its sharp fangs. So that seems pretty cool. So we do know that Lugamon has two baby forms, as Digimon tend to do, but we haven't seen the designs for the adult, perfect, and mega forms. We do know that it's got the DIM card, and we get to see the rest of the roster from the DIM card, but we don't get to see the adult, perfect, and mega forms, which I'm actually appreciative of. As of recording this, we still haven't seen these stronger forms. But at the moment, I'm fairly happy to not, because it means that there's more to reveal when we actually do get Digimon Seekers in just over a month away. In terms of my own coverage of it, I'll be presumably doing video reviews every week, like I've been doing for Ghost Game. But I'm thinking of also, maybe in terms of podcast, doing a reading of each chapter and just putting it up on the podcast feed. That's what I'm thinking anyway, just in case people don't want to read it or they prefer listening to an audiobook. But that's just what I'm thinking. I previously had started the Digimon novelization in podcast form, but that was set off track when Colin came out and then immediately Ghost Game. So I'll be doing something similar to the adventure novelization. So in any case, that's everything we know so far about Digimon Seekers. Again, I'm very, very excited for Digimon Seekers. I'm not like the biggest novel person, but I'm glad we get something that's fairly new from the franchise. It's nice that the Digimon franchise seems to be trying to keep it fresh in terms of the releases, and it's also nice that we don't just have anime to watch. It's something different, something new. And the story itself seems like something that's fairly cool. It seems like a new take. I do like when we get older characters for Digimon stories. Mostly they're just children. I tweeted about this the other day saying, hey look, adults who are chosen children, people saying, but what about Data Squad? And then you've got to remember that the two main characters in Data Squad were 14 years old. Masaru and Thomas are both 14. Yoshino is 18, but she's the exception. The other two, the red one and the blue one, they are 14 still. In this one, Eiji, who is our quote-unquote goggle kid, he is a 19-year-old, as we've read today. So in any case, that's all that we know so far, at least as of recording this. I'm very excited to be covering this. Let me know your thoughts and predictions about Digimon Seekers in the comment section below. Like this video if you're excited as I am, or just if you think Lugamon is a pretty cool design. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I will be doing more videos focused on Digimon Seekers. I'm very excited. I'm very much looking forward to the DIM card as well. And yeah, if you have subscribed, tell your friends, tell your family, tell your enemies, and of course, I'll see you in the next video. Bye!